Hey there guys, what's going on? So the long journey through these unforgiving East Coast temperatures continues here in this neck of the woods, but despite that and the feeling of recent malaise around here, that is by no means an excuse to forget about making cool new videos. Cool being a personal opinion, of course. But anyway, as I said, it has remained an importance to start thinking about making music reviews around here with all these great early albums that have come out so far, and despite the sluggish beginning, it's just a case of shrugging off the winter's chill. It's still out there, but things are heating up. And let's get that warm karma started off right with a little fun with collaboration, shall we? I can think of no better way to begin than throwing together a little Ben Harper, a dash of Charlie Musselwhite, stirring the pot, and calling it blues. This is their new album together called Get Up on the 45th installment of The Vinyl Corner. Let's begin. I have a right to get up. Where does one even attempt to begin when it comes to talking about two musicians with such star power and notoriety attached to them? Well, when you talk about Ben Harper, there are certainly quite a variety of words that you can use across the span of a 21-year career. Two-time Grammy winner, a multi-continental fan base, a history of activism, 12 career studio albums, 4 live records, collaborations with the likes of Danny Harrison, Joseph Arthur, the Blind Boys of Alabama, Eddie Vedder, Jack Johnson. The list truly does go on and on and on. And as for Charlie Musselwhite, well, it's difficult to find a blues musician whose stylings on the harp are more recognizable across such a lengthy span of time. In addition to releasing over 20 studio albums since the late 60s, it also proves difficult to find a musician who Musselwhite hasn't worked or been acquainted with. Whether it's the old blues men like Junior Wells, Muddy Waters, and Buddy Guy, or other contemporary artists like Tom Waits, NXS, Bonnie Raitt, and Eric Clapton, Musselwhite is quite the well-known figure. He was also the inspiration for Dan Aykroyd's character in the Blues Brothers films, and was also inducted into the Blues Hall of Fame back in 2010. So as you can see, the two coming together on the Get Up album was definitely a natural type of fit. Musselwhite is a blues man right down to his very core, and Harper also has the chops to fit in with the blues in addition to his explorations into folk, soul, rock, and reggae. They're each well-traveled veterans in their own right, and when you see two musicians who choose to come together like this, you can't help but get kind of excited. Hence why I'm here in this video to talk a little bit about it today. Hard to know exactly how this collaboration is going to match up when everything is said and done, but that's for a period of time that's way far off in the distance to see just yet. Right now, it's time to undergo a brand new review. This is Ben Harper and Charlie Musselwhite's new album, Get Up! And this is my review. But the song Don't Look Twice kicks in with its bluesy acoustic notes and light slide guitar, there's an inkling, a possibility, that something really excellent is coming along. Then Charlie Musselwhite comes in with that whisper-thin harmonica that does its trademark talking, and you get closer. Then the drums kick in, and that whisper becomes a yell that sends home the beginning of how exciting this collaborative journey is going to be. That enthusiasm bears immediate repeating on I'm In, I'm Out, and I'm Gone, as Musselwhite's harp squalls wheeze out behind a funky march and Ben Harper's vocal, which emerges so in charge and in command that he's like a preacher leading the holy procession on a march that does this genre of music proud. He's sounding as good as he ever has in his career, and it's wonderful to hear him embrace a mixture of angry fire, scorned comeuppance, and that muted joy that's always made him such a skilled talent in the first place. Things really kick up a notch with I Don't Believe a Word You Say, where Musselwhite's harmonica reaches a screeching peak and Harper unleashes Austin, Texas blues-sounding electric guitar riffs that sound like something out of his exploration with his Relentless 7 side project. But if anything, it's nice when the tone comes back down and it just sounds like Ben and Charlie are playing in a room together. They mesh like they've been doing this for a decade at least, and Harper's silky smooth velvet of a voice projects that vibe of somebody's been doing me so wrong in such a perfect manner. It's the type of thing that's been making the blues all its life, and Charlie Musselwhite just punches it home with his well-honed and legendary harp playing. I sit here in a daze, wishing I could change my ways.
let's not pretend it isn't what it is.
If anything, it's nice to hear Ben Harper take this newly straight-up blues direction with this collaboration. And while I know he's well-versed in the genre, this feels like something contemporary that took a step right out of the past. Maybe it's the fact that it's on a legendary label like Stax, maybe it's due to Charlie Musselwhite's status as one of the greatest blues harmonica players to ever be, or maybe it's just fantastic to hear such a purely rich blues rock record. Not mixed up with pop, not twisted into anything else, it just exists pure and upfront and ballsy. It's got its blood side out, if you will, and it shows such crystal clear energy all the way through. Not to mention, these songs don't just flow from point A to point B. There's actually nice jamming throughout, like with the tracks Get Up and All That Matters Now, where both Harper and Musselwhite get to flex their chops along with the rest of the band. So many records and bands and artists seem to focus on how to quickly get from the beginning to the end of a song, but it really takes a skill and a knack for music to take the songs beyond lyrics and meanderingly explore through their structure and what makes them what they are. And let me just reiterate it as many times as I can, these two really know how to make all this work. Anyway, my favorites from this one are the aforementioned I Don't Believe a Word You Say and I'm In, I'm Out, and I'm Gone, as well as the hand-clap-laden sing-along of We Can't End This Way and the morosely droning conclusion of All That Matters Now. In fact, when it comes to that last song, even if it has been a long, hard day and a long, hard life, it really is all that matters now to hear these two play together and make music. Ben Harper and Charlie Musselwhite have a great background in this thing we call blues, and fusing that knack together was one of the more fortuitous collaborations in blues rock, and just one of the best collaborations I've heard recently. Get Up can kick your ass, steal your heart, and leave you wanting more all at once. I give it a 9 out of 10.
There's a man on the corner, begging for help. And there's a man that walks past him, and he's drowning in wealth. Who doesn't understand? Who doesn't understand?
And as you've likely seen in my Vinyl Corner installments recently, you can find more extensive coverage and unboxing of this in another video done very, very recently, in fact, here on my channel. So of course, go check that out, and I hope you enjoyed some of my better late than never thoughts on Ben Harper and Charlie Musselwhite with Get Up. I gotta admit, it was a hell of a lot of fun to do a write-up about, and it's definitely one that I recommend if you like blues. It's definitely one that will find its way to really, really grow on you. But that's pretty much it for me here in this video, as my time is about up. So on behalf of this 45th installment of the Vinyl Corner here on This Dog Ate My Vlogs, as well as myself, keep your music flowing and your vinyl spinning. I will see you all very, very soon.